Welcome back, everyone. It's me, Jessica Brizuela, board-certified music therapist, bringing you yet another video session of Tuning the Soul with Jess. To keep up with the festive holidays, I've created another celebratory session for you today. So let's go ahead and get started with our welcome song. A one, two, three, four. Well, it's really good to see you. I hope you're feeling all right. Yes, it's really good to see you. I hope you're feeling all right. Well, it's time to sing and play now. To our heart's delight, we're singing, hello, everyone. Hello, everyone. Hello, everyone. It's time to say hello. Our theme for today is to celebrate a very special group of people, mothers. In the United States, Mother's Day is celebrated on the second Sunday in May. This year it falls on May 10th, which is the day it's celebrated every year regardless of whether it's Sunday or not, in some Latin American countries such as El Salvador, the country where my mother is from. To give us a little U.S. history of this beautiful day, we're going to start by going back to 1872. Julia Ward Howe, who wrote Battle Hymn of the Republic, first proposed Mother's Day in the hope that the tribute to mothers might extend a mood of peace to the country after many were distraught by the lives lost during the Civil War. However, the holiday was not approved. In 1908, Anna Jarvis created a campaign to set aside a day to honor all mothers because she believed a mother is, quote, the person who has done more for you than anyone in the world. However, it was rejected, joking that they would also have to proclaim a Mothers-in-Law Day. Jarvis continued her efforts, and by 1911, all U.S. states observed the holiday. Finally, in 1914, President Woodrow Wilson signed a proclamation designating Mother's Day as the second Sunday in May as a national holiday to honor mothers. Now, the phrase mother knows best is one that many of us have heard. Is it true? Well, depending on the situation, most likely yes. Mothers have already experienced many of the same types of things their children have yet to experience. Thus, mothers feel compelled to offer their advice, whether or not it's wanted. As long as we know that her advice comes from a place of love and care, it's the most important thing. Our first song reminds me of this phrase because our chorus is a piece of advice given from a mother to her child and then passed on from generations to come. The piece of advice, which is also the name of the song, says, que será, será, whatever will be, will be. Please join me in singing, que será, será. One, two, three. When I was just a little girl, I asked my mother, what would I be? Will I be pretty? Will I be rich? Here's what she said to me. Que será, será, whatever will be, the future's not ours to see. Que será, será, what will be. When I grew up and fell in love, I asked my sweetheart, what lies ahead? Will we have rainbows day after day? Here's what my sweetheart said. Que será, será, whatever will be, the future's not ours to see. Que será, será, what will be. Now I have children of my own. They ask their mother, what will I be? Will I be handsome? Will I be rich? I tell them tenderly. Que será, será, whatever will be, the future's not ours to see. Que será, será, what will be, que será, será. was made famous by the beloved Doris Day, who was close to her mother, Alma. In her 1975 autobiography, Doris Day describes her mother as a darling woman and added, "My mother is a very barrel house, loves to yak it up and enjoy herself, loves parties and the more people the better. She's in her 70s now, lives with me, and I swear she seems to have as much pep and go as she did when I was a girl." Now, Doris was also a mother herself and gave birth at the young age of 18 to her only child, her son Terry. Since she was so young and continued to work, her mother Alma helped to raise Terry, especially during the first 7 years of his life when Day was on the road. As Day returned from her travels, she stood by her son's side and they developed a very close relationship that lasted throughout their lives. Being a mother is a difficult task, especially when a mother has to be far from her child, but her love shines on. Our next song comes from a 1941 Disney classic where Baby Elephant visits his mother, who is locked up in a circus wagon. The mom cradles him with her trunk and offers him words of comfort, telling him she will always have his back. The song is called Baby Mine, and it comes from the film named after an elephant, Dumbo.
Baby mine, don't you cry. Baby, your head close to my heart, never to part, baby of mine. Little one, when you play, don't you mind what they say. Let your eyes sparkle and shine, never to tear, baby of mine.
There's a beautiful tradition on Mother's Day of giving flowers. The popular flower of Mother's Day is the carnation. Giving a red carnation signifies respect of a living mother, while a white carnation is worn or given in honor of a mother who has passed away. When Doris Day's mother Alma passed away, she said, "I miss her very much, but I'm happy in the knowledge that she's having a grand reunion with all her dear family and friends who she missed so much." Alma's tombstone reads, "Beloved Mother." This next song, similar to the white carnation, is to remember mothers who are no longer with us. This song is a Spanish song written by Juan Gabriel, who wrote it for his late mother, describing that this is more than a song. It is a meditation on love, a tribute to mothers in heaven. To translate the lyrics of his chorus, he says, "How I wish that you were living, that your dear eyes had never closed so I could be looking at them. Eternal love and unforgettable. Sooner or later, I will be with you to continue loving each other." The song is called Amor Eterno, which translates to eternal love. I will play it on the harp as an instrumental. Feel free to follow along in either English or Spanish with the lyrics provided below. And as you listen, meditate on the wonderful memories of a mother who is no longer with us.
Thank you.
Unconditional love and a mother's wisdom. These words encapsulate mothers around the world. Some say moms have a sixth sense when it comes to their child's, as they are so in tune with their needs, which is precisely why their life advice should not be ignored. I want you to think about some piece of advice or fond memory that your mother or mother figure has given you, or that you have given as a mother or grandmother yourself. We will close out our theme today with the popular 1960s song of advice by the Shirelles, which says, "Mama said there'll be days like this, there'll be days like this, my mama said." Here we go. Let's start out with singing oohs. Said there'll be days like this, there'll be days like this, my mama said. Mama said there'll be days like this, there'll be days like this, my mama said. I was walking the other day when everything was going fine. I met a little boy named Billy Joe and then almost lost my mind. Mama said there'll be days like this, there'll be days like this, my mama said. Mama said there'll be days like this, there'll be days like this, my mama said.
Mama said, mama said, hey,
don't
hey,
you worry.
And I want to wish all the mothers out there a happy Mother's Day, regardless of what day you're watching. Because as my grandmother used to say, every day is Mother's Day. So let's go ahead and close out our session today by singing goodbye. A one, two, three, four, bye-bye. A so long, a farewell, bye-bye. Adios, arrivederci, sayonara. I'll see you later, alligator. After a while, a crocodile. I'll see you soon, a baboon. Until then, a penguin. It's time to go. We're singing bye-bye, everyone. Bye-bye, everyone. Bye-bye, everyone. It's time to say goodbye. Thank you all for singing today. Thank you all for watching today. Thank you all for being here. It's time to say goodbye. Goodbye, everyone, and happy Mother's Day.